We needed a little getaway. One that had sun, art, and most of all, food. So we flew down to Miami for a quick weekend getaway to the vibrant Cuban heart of Miami, Little Havana.
So whenever we visit Miami and Little Havana, it feels like we've left the U.S. without ever needing a passport.
Can I see your passport, Rachel?
Yes.
I mean, this is a place where English feels like a second language. Now, Cuba is known for its coffee, and we are huge coffee snobs.
Our favorite things in the morning is our coffee. What are we bringing with us?
A little coffee machine.
So now it's time to go try some Cuban coffee. We came to one of the most famous spots on Calle Ocho. We're at Old Havana Cuban Bar and Cocina. And we're gonna get two famous items that Cuba is known for. First up,
we're gonna get a cafe cubano, also called a cafecito or Cuban coffee.
Now, an interesting fact of Cuban coffee, it is a small portion, very thick, very dark, and also made with brown sugar. Now, why is it made this way? Well, some of this is a bit of an urban legend. They don't fully know why, but a lot of it is believed to date back to the rations, because Cubans were only given a small amount of coffee, and so they had to make that stretch and go the whole month. So they would make very small portions. Why is it brown sugar? Well, the other thing, same thing with the rations, had to do with the socialist communist views and the idea that they were only given the brown sugar, which was the cheaper, less refined sugar. So they put those two together, they made their coffee, and when they came to Miami and Little Havana, they continued this recipe and this tradition.
Very educational, thank you.
You're welcome.
Wow.
All right, so we got our coffee, and you can see this is a very small shot, and that has to do with that history of basically using a very small amount of coffee, mixing it with the sugar. Now there's a little cream in here, and basically how this is made is when the espresso starts, they put in a little sugar, stir it up. So basically that caramelizes the sugar, and what that does is it forms a little crema. So you have the crema from the coffee, and you have the crema from the sugar as well, which makes a very rich and delicate and one of a kind coffee. Ooh. That's a rush. That is a rush of sugar and a rush of caffeine. That's nice. Cheers, everyone. Now it's time for the fun stuff. We had the coffee. Now it's time for mojito. Now this place makes a very good mojito, and you can always tell a good mojito by this. What is this? This is sugar cane. This is where all the sweet goodness comes from. And the other thing is, they don't muddle the mint. It's big leaves. Why do you do that? Well, I learned from a bartender, you never want to have a pretty girl with green stuff stuck in her teeth. And that's what this will prevent. No one's gonna suck in a whole mint leaf into their mouth. They might chew on it, but it's not gonna get stuck in the teeth. So those two things really showcase if it is a good mojito and they've taken their time and care to make a good one. Sipping on this is like stepping back to the Cuban Revolution and just enjoying history. Or maybe it's like Hemingway when he used to live and write The Man in the Sea. Is that the name of the book? I think that is. You know, it's whatever you want it to be. It's going to be good times. So cheers to you guys. Be sure to try the mojitos here, because when you walk in, the bar is lined with like hundreds of cups prepared for mojitos. So I don't know how many they do a day, but it's a lot.
So Little Havana wasn't always like this. Actually, it all started around the 1960s in a very unexpected way. But before we explain how this all happened, we want to talk to you about Cuts.
Now, Cuts are my go-to shirts, and now that we live in the Northeast, they're also my go-to hoodies. If you've been following this channel, you know how much we love Cuts. And the good news is, Cuts is expanding their line. Not only are they offering shirts and hoodies, but also sweatpants, vests, jackets, and even more. Now, we want to extend the gift of Cuts to you, so click the link below, use the code ROMRU, and you can get 15% off your purchase of Cuts. If you're looking for a recommendation, I love their new vests in black and the long sleeve Henley in navy. Okay, that's enough about Cuts. Now let's get back to the history lesson about Little Havana.
After Fidel Castro took over Cuba in 1959, there was a mass exodus of Cubans to Miami in the 1960s, with most of the Cubans settling right here in Little Havana. Now, many of these Cubans were flown to the US on a Freedom flight. These flights ran twice daily, five times per week, from 1965 to 1973. And they brought an estimated 300,000 refugees to the US. Many of these political refugees thought this new home would be temporary, hoping Castro would be deposed, but unfortunately, that was not the case. And serendipitously, Little Havana was born. All right, the time has come to eat the best Cuban sandwiches in Little Havana at Sandwich. So, no more introduction, just let's eat.
Hello.
How are you?
Doing well. Should we order with you?
Yes.
All right.
So the menu's gonna be right behind you guys, if you guys wanna take a better look at that.
All right, let's do the croqueta. The order coordinates. And the Cuban sandwich. Look at this cheese. Oh my goodness.
Does it look good?
Oh, it doesn't look good. It looks great. There was cheese just dripping off, being like, eat me.
Come here, I'm gonna eat ya!
Look at how much cheese is on that side. Wow. We got a Cuban sandwich that I've already started eating. This is phenomenal. You got so many layers of pork in this Cuban sandwich that they hand grind here, cook fully, and then press with a panini to keep hot. Sorry, it's dripping on me. And we have a lot of cheese. And when I say a lot of cheese, I mean a lot of cheese. And then you got some pickles in there. I don't know what else, it's just amazing. Onions and delicious, crispy but soft bread.
All right, this is one of those diamonds in the rough. It is in a very simple strip mall, but this thing shines and stands out. That was an amazing food sandwich.
Wow, the best I've ever had.
What's nice about it is it's a cool exploratory day to come to Little Havana, take the walk, and we're not done yet. So we're gonna go back to where we came from.
All right.
So we're ending our food tour in the way that any food tour should be ended, that is with some ice cream.
Oh yeah.
We're at Azúcar, which is a Cuban gelato factory.
Artisanal ice cream.
Now, they're known for their famous Cuban flavors, and we just went with the basics, the Cookie Monster and mint ice cream.
But if you want to be traditional, you should order the Abuela Maria, Grandma Maria. Now that is their most famous flavor, as well as Cafe Con Leche.
I like this,
delicious.
This is amazing.
And perfect on a hot Miami day.
Oh yeah.
Cartagena, Bogotá, Cartagena, Villa y Cartagena.